Association welcomes you to the Woolsack Mikado, or broccoli japonaise. But unlike Gilbert and Sullivan's Mikado, our musical potpourri does not take place in the land of Titipoo or some Victorian nippon. Rather, we seek to transport you, honorable audience, to a still more rarefied climb, the Boulder Valley, which you may want to think of as a fraternity house on the hill, a public house on the mall, a tragic tea house, we're not sure where yet, a turkey house in Longmont, an outhouse in Ward, a body house just about anywhere, but which we know as a vestigial commune, encompassing all of the above and a good deal more. A line of baffling banter, recherche, repartee, and pseudo-sophisticated dialectics typified by the writings of the esteemed president of the Colorado Bar Association, whom all of you know by repute as a fount of all forms of philosophical fripperies and quite a few fuzzy and downright funny ideas of the only in Boulder variety. Now, to set the scene, a group of Japanese investors has arrived at the Pain and Suffering International Airport. They have just announced the formation of a new consortium with the stated purpose to always buy Colorado. Apparently, Governor Romer's discussed his mercantilist notions on his latest junket to Japan, and his promotional slogan, which was overheard in a sushi bar, has become a major focus of Japanese investment here in the United States. And so, we give you the Japanese and their arrival having cleaved the demise of the Liberal Democratic Party only to create the Boulder Bar Association's own recruit scandal.
Sit down, goddammit! we've had a yen or two from Colorado, and I am glad to see that you're here, ready to buy it.
But Governor-san, you don't understand. We want a package deal.
We
want to
buy, as you say, the whole enchilada.
Getting Gabuda.
Rock, stock, and barrel.
And follow Max.
Whatever the bad is.
We're ready to seal the deal on the spot.
We already own a good bit of the mountains.
Except for the part steal over the Texans.
And we're ready to buy up the rest. We're here to buy Colorado.
But I didn't mean to sell the whole state, only a piece.
First, you have to give us a chance to convene some lumpy oatmeal breakfast and try to put this together.
And while we're at it, time out for just a brief commercial message brought to you by the City and County of Oz.
Faced with difficulty in convincing major airlines to support the building of a new airport, state and local officials have been exploring other options. Today, Mayor Freddie P. Nunn and Governor Roy Rogers Romer announced a breakthrough agreement with the Soviet airline Aeroflot to help fund the new Pena and Suffering International Airport, tentatively named Staple Gun 2. Communist Party Chief Mike Gorbachev welcomed the agreement as an important step in showing off what he called his glass nuts. And demonstrating how once you've conciliated one striker, you'll inevitably generate a pair of strikers. And how his policies are a cure for whatever that is, and anything else that ails you. Mr. Gorbachev!
Thank you.
back to you, Chris? This boulder? Does a bear spit in the woods? Is the Pope Polish? Is that Freddy Peanut or Trigger with whom I just saw you?
Beats me.
Look, Chris, I need some help from the Colorado Bar. I need it right away. The Japanese have sent up a delegation to buy a piece of the Rockies. And I need to figure out what the legal profession can come up with to sell or trade with.
Now look, Roy, the Japanese aren't much into lawyers. Having only one for every 9,000 people, whereas we have one for every 350 people, which does work out to about 1/30th of the bar dues revenues. On the other hand, there is a shortage there, and nature abhors a void as much as it does avoid it.
Look, Chris, I know that you and your friend, including Freddy and me, have an act of racialism just about anything. So how about helping us out?
Look,
if you guys can come up with TV ads to seduce and swindle widows and orphans, surely you can figure out some way to trade some services with the Japanese.
By the way, where did Freddy go?
Oh, he'll be right back. He went to get donuts. And it is 100 miles before the call.
Perhaps we could trade them some great baseball player, or perhaps some famous baseball announcer.
That's a great idea, and the Chicago Cubs announcer would be just right for the job.
But he's already under contract, so we can't commit to Harry Carey.
We've got to come up with some unique Colorado commodity, such as raw Rocky Mountain oysters for the sushi bars, or ingenue ski bunnies for the geisha recruiters.
How about trading them a whole group of people? How about trading them a batch of lawyers, for starters?
That does appeal to the P.T. Barnum in me, Roy, which is the core value taught to us in law school. But, got this thing screwed up so royally, why don't we call in the Boulder County Bar and see what they think of the idea?
Let's
trade them to Japan.
That's the spirit!
It seems to me that the Boulder County Bar fits that old saw about lawyers and why they are so much preferable to white rats. First of all, there are so many more of them, particularly in Boulder County. And secondly, they aren't nearly so warm and fuzzy, so you don't get so attached to them. But there are some things that even white rats won't do. Because of it, there is a significant overpopulation in Boulder County, and we have to think up something more than just tough disciplinary rules or aspirational or otherwise incomprehensible to mortals ethical considerations. But we need some real sophistry growth control.
You know, Chris, we Boulder lawyers spend a lot of our time shoveling smoke, and we could use a new challenge.
And it would be a boon to some of us slightly older members of the bar if we had a little less competition from some of you young whippersnappers. We might even be able to make some money on that. Perhaps we could give a rat free to every lawyer. If we traded enough of them to Japan, we could wreak havoc with their economy.
Wait a minute. How do we get the Japanese to buy us?
Well, the marketing is going to be up to you guys. But based on the Boulder Bar's net trade surplus and bizarre legal theories, I have great faith in you all.
Look, it's not really up to us alone. Let's call in our executive director, Mitch Korchak, and see if sometimes call our dead mother, and see if she can come up with some hokey angle to make this thing fit together. Let's call in the rest of the Boulder County Bar, though, and see what they think.
I don't like the idea of being shipped abroad like chattel. But last year I didn't make enough for my law practice to pay for the new sunroof on my BMW.
Sad but true. We can't survive on herbal tea and sprouts alone.
There's just one little problem. It's a dishonor to go to a lawyer in Japan.
What do they do for fun? They can't make war.
They don't have football.
They work long hours and they never change jobs or marriages.
They're so straight they make Eisenhower look like a hippie.
You're right. We've got to introduce them to America's favorite and most sophisticated contact sport, litigation!
Conspicuous confrontation!
Ritualized conflict!
Bloodless aggression! Sublimated polymorphous perversity!
It'll be bigger than Nintendo!
So it's a deal! A trade will be made! Let's hit it!
Thank you.
for us.
Well, don't worry. The owner Helmsley is going to build a hotel, manage a hotel.